And I don't know how I don't know what these means. I don't know what it means, you know. So I guess I'll find out tomorrow. Because I'll find out tomorrow because he said he would do it. He will do it. Yeah. You understand me?
Yeah, but what's he going to do? Who's going to do what?
Gene.
Oh, Gene.
Yeah. He said he would come and do it.
Fix your camera?
No. Explain to me what these things are.
Oh, okay. Okay, I didn't know what you were
yeah.
talking about.
I'm not sure what they are.
Oh, okay.
And, I used to know, but I don't know. Yeah, this was on the 30th, but that's where we find out, better find out that, but you don't know this. You don't know this.
No.
And I don't either. But I want you to do for me. Okay. Monsanto, we talked about Monsanto last time, the company, the seeds, Monsanto. Did we talk about that?
I think you brought that up.
It's bad. Bad. This Monsanto, I think it's in Italian, he's it's an Italian, and the Monsanto is bad. All the seeds are no more. You go to the supermarket. You go to the supermarket and you go and you buy vegetables and fruit. Mainly fruit, like watermelon, oranges, let's see, I know the watermelon and oranges, wine is wine. What's made of is
grapes.
They have no seeds.
Oh, seedless grapes.
Yeah, and they taste terrible. They taste terrible. It tastes like it tastes I don't know how to say it. It tastes no good. You take a bite and it tastes like you don't know whether it's orange or what it is. It's bland. It's bland. I don't know how to say this. Bland. Blah,
yeah,
no.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me see. So today is the 6th. Okay. And talking talking about Monsanto. I think this is white. I think this is white.
Monsanto.
Yeah, you know, have you heard of them? Have you ever heard of them?
I heard of the name.
Yeah. Monsanto is. They in the United States there is a law that you don't have to put anything for foods. You don't have to put anything for foods.
No,
nothing. In Europe, you have to put all the things that you have, whether you got seeds or no seeds or whatever, you have to write it down and put in on the thing so that you can see it. But you in the United States, in Europe, you've got to do it. In the United States, you don't have to do it. And not just that. Then they, it's a big problem. Then the farmers go in and put the farmers and Monsanto, like here's a farmer and here's Monsanto. Then Monsanto wind and wind. Here's Monsanto and here's the farmers. Here's the farmers and here's Monsanto. These are facts. These are facts. No. These are facts, okay? Okay, so I don't know the names of anybody. I used to know the name, but I have a hard time with it, a hard time. Anyway, here's the farm and here's Monsanto. The wind blows. And then the seeds all over the place. And then Monsanto take them to court.
Oh, yeah.
And they take him to court. He didn't want. He said that no, I'm gonna just keep my land, but the thieves be gone on the seas now, and so the farmer goes broke because he hasn't got enough money to deal with these people. He has enough money. That is bad. I can't really explain it to you better, but I'll send you a movie. But the thing is, you don't like to watch more than 5 minutes or so. You don't like to watch. And I can't find any I can't find what's taken a long time. And you haven't got much time for that.
Right. I'm busy.
Well, you know.
At my stage of life, I don't need to learn too much more.
Yeah, right. I know.
You know, it won't do me a lot of good because I can't put it to a lot of good use. A lot. If I spend a lot of time studying that, it's of no use because I can't help anybody with it or that, you might say, because I'm doing too many other things to get involved in something more. I got enough to do and I got enough to think about and I got enough problems to work out that I don't need any more.
Yeah, I know.
So I just sit, lay back and take it easy and listen to you talk.
Well, I don't talk much.
No. But you're really coming on, you know. I mean, every time you come in, you got about 20 minutes right now. I mean, just a few minutes here, you got 20 minutes over about telling me about Monsanto. And you've done pretty good with it. I mean, you brought up some things in your mind. Your mind went and got a couple things. Of course, there's some things so deep you can't bring them up, so you have to go over those for the time being. But some other time, that'll come to you. When you talk to somebody else about this, then maybe those other things will come to mind.
Yeah. I don't know. I tried so hard.
Yeah, you do. You do. But trying real hard does bring it up. If you didn't try real hard, you wouldn't get nothing. So you get pieces and bits and pieces by trying. Because you think of something else sometimes. When you're trying to think of this here, something else will come to your mind.
Yeah.
So that's what you're doing is you can't do nothing else but do what you're doing to recover what you lost. Hmm. Hoping that different things will come together up there.
Well, I wanted to talk about ink.
Ink.
Ink. Particularly with
brother.
What?
With brother.
Yeah. Yeah, if you could take this. Takes it and
put it up there?
Yeah.
Okay. The machine, the printer.
The printer and the ink. The ink. Can I?
Sure, go right ahead.
Okay. This is exactly like mine.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a little bit different model, but exactly like mine.
Oh.
You know that this guy is still coming?
I have no idea. I haven't heard from him. I don't know. I don't know nothing more than what I've told you.
And you don't know where he's here? Here in the park or?
Not now.
Oh. What happened?
I don't know. He's not in the park. I don't know where he is or what
happened. Yeah, but
maybe he died.
Wait. He moved?
I don't know. He left.
He left.
I don't know whether he stayed with somebody here in the park or whether he lived in the park or all I know, he brought me this to fix and I fixed it and he said he'd be back.
What was wrong with it?
I forgot. My mind won't go back that far. That's a miracle. I go back and remember what I did with that.
Let's see. Goodness, I wonder if I have one. You know, it says.
Oh.
And I wonder if I have one.
I don't
Siri the drum. CD1.
Oh, CD-ROM, yeah.
Did you get that? Did you get that?
No. That's all I got.
Can I?
Sure, go ahead.
Yeah, here it is. Huh. Here it is. See?
Oh, okay.
Damn. So I don't know whether I had one or not. Maybe. Oh, I think I do.
In a box someplace.
Yeah. You see, when I first got here. Harriet took me, and this was on the first year.
Okay.
Because I had to have one. Mm-hmm. You know, I do things, and I gotta make copies and
right.
stuff.
Right.
So, I don't know. I think I do. I have a brother that I think I do. I was so confused, but I managed to not see. I managed to I don't know if I got this, but this, I think maybe, I don't know, maybe I gotta find out.
Mm-hmm.
I was determined to get work. Determined to make it work, and I didn't know how to make it where this thing has a This thing has a Okay, this.
That's the CD-ROM, yeah.
No.
No?
It has,
Oh, the wireless. Yeah, it's wireless.
Wireless. So does mine.
Is it?
Yeah. But I don't know how to do it. Mm-hmm. I don't know how to, so what I did was this is what I did.
Oh, USB, yeah.
Yeah. Because I don't know how else to do anything else, so I took a plug, USB, mm-hmm. and I ran it. Somewhere here. Can I turn on the light?
Yeah, switch right there.
Can I, okay. Oh yeah. Yeah. This has different. This look.
Probably different model.
Yeah, this is different than mine. Mm-hmm. Oh well, no. This
is the LAN, and this is the USB. There it is down here.
Yeah, but it has. USB is different.
No. This is what they call the this is why they call it USB, because that's a USB. But this here is a printer. This is a printer connection.
You're
squealing, yeah.
Yeah.
So that goes to your printer.
Can you hear it?
Mm-hmm. Oh. It's not doing it now. It's all, when I turn my head a certain way. Here.
What is the name for this? This. You. this is USB, right? What is the name of this?
I have no idea.
Oh.
I don't even think it has a name.
Oh, really?
It's a plug for a printer. Most all printers have that plug. Most all printers have that plug. And I don't know.
Really?
I never knew that it had a name because they call it a USB connection.
Oh.
And it's because of that there. And so that this is still called a USB, although it's not. No, I don't know. There might be, but nobody uses it. They say, I need a USB to hook up my printer to a thing, and that's what you'll get.
Yeah, I have one. Mm-hmm. I had one.
The modems will have that. Some modems will have the same.
Yeah, I have a modem. Modem. What is it that? Well, wait. It's a good thing we're doing this. It's a good thing. So, let's see. Okay, and then it has like this. So you have land, and USB. USB. Okay. And then, yeah. You know, I used to work on this. I used to work before the stroke. I used to work on this. Okay, so then you said USB. It's a USB
cable.
USB cable. Is this the right way for cable?
The A should go between the C and
why?
C. The A should go between the C and the A. K, B, O. Cable.
Cable and then cable. Cable. And then cable, and then printer. What are you said?
What they call it in here.
Oh, okay.
I don't
find
it in here.
Okay.
Because they should have spelled it out here that you need this. You need all these supplies, but I don't see it. Someplace they should. Packing list is what they're looking for. Unpack the machine and check the components. Oh, here we go. Well, no, it don't. It just has telephone, product registration, accessory order form, CD-ROM, and user's guide. They don't say nothing about that cable. And I don't see no cable here. And there's no cable. It should have been there. There's no cables back here. I've been through all this. I don't know.
Let me see. Let me see this. So. It's got interface. Is that good? I mean,
interface or, cable. Well,
it's not. I don't know what it means.
Interface. It just means it's a cable that goes. In interface, is a cable that goes inside.
Oh, it's not.
It's not a name for that.
Oh, I see. You said. When you were talking, you said. When you were talking about the printer. No, not printer, the USB, mm-hmm. And you said, you asked me that USB that, I think USB that, I forget what you said. What did you said, what did you say that, oh.
This is he.
Okay, and just so you know, this is Amanda Thomas calling on behalf of the Breast Cancer Financial Assistance Fund. And I'm with Corporations for Character, a paid professional fundraiser.
Fundraiser. This is no fundraiser. What are you calling me for? They didn't have a name, they just had ACR something.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe that is something.
That's it, probably, you know, the thing is, he probably works for so much an hour, and she has to greet. She has to go and,
oh, yeah.
You know, even though she doesn't like it either. I should tell, hey, I am a stroke. So do you remember how you used to say it? You said this, that the cable to
all right, you see, they don't call that plug or anything. They just say connect the phone cord from the computer modem to the telephone. Or see, and I'm looking to find this on this Dell. This is a Dell. And so far, they don't even say anything about that cable.
But what did you say when you were talking about the you say that you must be cable that connects something. Connects
the printer to the computer. The USB cable that connects the printer to the computer.
Okay.
That's what this is.
Can you write that down?
Yeah, I can write that down. Yeah. don't pay this. See, that's what I say. They don't call it any, that I know of. Anybody that I've talked to since that cable with the little N. That's what that is. The little N. The US cable with a U. USB cable. Well, there it is there. USB cable. To computer. I'm sure that's what I said. That's the USB cable that connects the printer to the computer.
Yeah. Okay. So, USC, and he said, land. Land is. What is that land? Land. What is that?
That's the land.
Yeah, but Okay. I know that we talked about this before, long time ago, but I forget. Name for this. You understand me?
No.
The
name for this.
Yeah, the name.
What's this?
USB land I thought I wrote it down. Do you understand me? No?
No, because I don't know any name for the land. Land is land.
Master Boot Record. Oh, this is I can't. USB. Yeah, here it is. System configuration utility. System configuration utility.
It has nothing to do with this. This is your on your computer.
Oh, I got the wrong thing. Oh, that's. Yeah.
That's the config. That's all those things that start up when you start your computer. That's the config system.
Oh. Well then, what is USB stamp? What is USB?
Universal.
Yeah, that's right. Universal. Can you write it down?
Universal service bar.
Yeah, could you write it down?
Universal service bar.
And land doesn't have, it has to have, does land, does that got any?
I've been looking and I can't find anything.
Oh, I see.
All it says is land.
Oh, right.
I can't find no other name for it.
I'm just curious. Maybe
it'll come to you?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's possible.
It's possible.
Your mind is now starting to work with the brother printer, and something might break loose, and you might say, oh, I know that name. I remember the light bulb lit up a long time ago on something. They just do not spell them out. It's like I say, when you go to get one, they'll say the USB cable that hooks my printer up to the computer. And usually the guy that's selling the stuff knows what they're talking about. So they don't call it a particular name.
Now, what?
Now that's all I find on the cable. And you see, they just call it USB and LAN. And whenever they talk about it, they don't talk about it in any other. They call that cable anything else except LAN and USB.
Right. Now, I want to talk about ink. Mm-hmm. Ink. Yeah. Now, okay, so let's
okay, I guess it just hasn't been used for a while.
So, okay. Okay, now this is the colors, right?
Right.
Now you were telling me that you discovered something you discovered
the ink filler,
and you discovered how to
fill. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Does it work like this? I mean,
they work just exactly like this.
Okay.
Oops, that's not it. This, the same thing that's in there is this, where when you put that in there, there's a thing that goes in there.
Okay, hole. Hold on a second. Can we hold on a second? Okay.
Okay, I'm waiting. I'm over. I'm holding.
So, Now, this is the same thing as this. Mm-hmm. And so
you see that hole there?
Uh-huh.
That's the same as this hole here.
Let me see.
That hole is where there's a thing inside there that goes in that hole. There's this thing that's inside this computer that goes into here. Now, inside here,
hold on.
Like that.
Let me take a picture of it.
Inside there is like that.
Okay, so
this will go in here. Same thing, it'll go in there. And if we twist it, it comes in and you squirt ink inside the cartridge. Now, that's a valve. This is a valve. Show you what the valve looks like. Little tiny thing like that, see? And that's the hole that this will go into. This is the valve that closes up as soon as you, when you take it out of here, that closes up so ink don't come flowing out. Also, to keep ink in while it's in there like that. If they didn't have some sort of valve, all the ink would run out into the tray. So they have to have some way closing it up. So they just have this rubber so that rubber comes together. And what I do, I put the thing, it goes right through here. Now, this is the way it goes. If I twist it, you see? See how that comes up through there? Now, when I take that up, that'll close up. That closes up there, no ink can come out. So I can fill these cartridges with that needle and go in there. So I haven't had a brother empty to do it with, but I've got some yellow ink coming and I've got a yellow cartridge that's empty, so I'm going to be filling this. Which is the same, you see, it works the same as what that does. Because there's a thing that's in the computer, or in the printer, that's goes into this, and goes into that, to open that.
Well, maybe, my nose is running. Mm-hmm. Do you know, is it running or is it?
I don't know. Linda. I don't feel your nose running.
No, but sometimes it's been running and I don't even know.
Yeah.
You know, and the doctor gave me some the doctor gave me some medicine, pills. Mm-hmm. But I don't like taking it. I took it, maybe three times. And, you know, you got to take it and wait for the morning to take it. I don't want to keep taking that. Do you have stuff you got to take? Have you got stuff that you have to take?
6 in the morning, 7 at night.
What do you have?
Zocor, thyroid pills, aspirin, Benazol for my heart, Anadrol for my heart. What the other Zeta for cholesterol, something else for cholesterol, I forgot the name, something else for cholesterol. I've been taking for 20 years from this doctor. I was at the doctor Monday, he just changed some of my thyroid pills to something else. He says, if you're taking that too long at a time, it starts affecting your organs. You know, it's not good for your organs. Whichever organ, I don't know, but he changed it so that it wouldn't damage my organs. And at my age, I don't give a darn. It don't make much difference.
Well, do you think this is the same or different?
Than yours?
No.
Same, different than what? Compare that to what?
No. This is exactly the same as I got.
I don't know.
No. Exactly the same as I got.
I don't know if it is.
No.
You say it is?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought you was asking me if it was.
No. And this, because I've noticed that the ink, it just runs.
That's because that valve is bad.
Oh.
It got old and the rubber don't come together anymore, so the rubber's open up and the ink's coming out.
I see.
It's too old. The thing is too old. And also, when you take it out and put it back in, it deforms those a little bit. You really should leave it in until it's completely done. If you take it out when it's still got ink in it, then when you put it back in, it has stretched that little rubber in there, and that don't come together. The rubber just comes apart because it's...
No, but this these were it says when the it says right? Mm-hmm. It says it's time to fill it up. Mm-hmm. It's time. Mm-hmm. The machine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I don't know if the machine or what I mean. This machine is excess. You have to throw it away.
I know.
And then you have to take it, push. If it doesn't, you have
I got a printer just like that one that uses these.
Right.
That printer does this exactly the same thing you're saying.
Okay.
It says it's time to change cartridge. Or it says it's out of date. It'll say that. Change the yellow cartridge. But I press, or they say, press this button over here on this side. So I press that button. Then it says, your machine will be out of warranty. And down the bottom it says, press for OK. So then I press the center for OK, and the machine goes and prints. And I keep that up. Until this will not print yellow anymore. Because they got a thing in here that wants you to change this thing before this is run out. Two things. They sell more ink cartridges that way. Because you throw away and you go buy a new one, see? The other thing is, sometimes when you run it all the way down, you may get a little air in the line. And then when the people buy a new cartridge and put it in, they got air in the line and it won't print. So they take it back out and take it back in and says this won't print. So the company don't want people bringing one back. A new one back that has air in the line, because it would suck air. If it's not sucking ink, it'll suck air. If there's no ink in there, what else is to suck but air? Are you understanding what I'm saying?
Yeah. So
that's why what you're reading up here, all that stuff, that's why it is. They're trying to protect their machine and sell more of these and not have people say it won't work.
On my machine, like this, it says it's different. Well, I mean, many. They're all different. Mm-hmm. They're all different. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't say to pull. It doesn't say to do anything. It doesn't say to do anything. But you have to, it says you have to follow the directions. Mm-hmm. So, and when the thing comes up, like time to save a yellow, white. And then I have no way to I have to change it to yellow, otherwise I don't know what to do.
Will it print?
No, it won't.
It won't print.
And that's the problem I have. It won't print. But I'm not saying that I know, because I don't know. I don't know. That's why I'm asking you. that is why the whole thing. I forgot about this. I forgot. And I and the same thing is at my house. And I tried, believe me, I tried several times to do something, but I couldn't find. I just don't know, but that doesn't mean that I know. I mean, I haven't figured it out. I haven't figured it out.
You said it and didn't know it.
Yeah. So.
Chances are, yes, if you haven't used it for a long time and then that came up, and if you've taken the cartridge out and put it back in, it's locked it up so that you gotta have good cartridges in there before it's gonna work again. Yeah, in your case, I think that's right. As long as the machine won't work. Have you got an ink gauge that tells you how much ink is in the cartridges?
Yeah.
You got that?
Yeah.
Does it say that there's ink in the cartridges?
Yeah, that's why I got, right now, blue is like this.
Yeah.
You got black, yellow, blue, red.
Mm-hmm.
And blue is down to what I need to it's down to then the printer will say it's time to change. I can't do it. I mean, what you can do is you go like I tried this already. It didn't work. I tried it already and it didn't work. I said, okay, so so change, okay, change. It shows a picture of the thing, a change. So I open it up, and that time, and I pulled it out, and then I figured I'll just put it back in. But it doesn't work.
It don't work that way.
Yeah, I gotta get back. I have to get a brand new cartridge.
That's what they say. Yeah.
Yeah, but
now they should have that, all that information in here.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Let me see if I can find it. Everything you're talking about, they should have it in here. See what they say about it before you install it. That's Macintosh. That's the wiring. Anything about the ink. I think I'm in the Mexican. There's install ink cartridges, but it don't have anything to do.
See, that's what it is.
Yeah.
You got. And then I just take it out and put it back in, but it didn't work.
Do not take out ink cartridges if you do not need to replace them. If you do, it may reduce the ink quality and the machine will not know the quality of the ink left in the cartridge. Do not shake the ink cartridge. Do not repeatedly insert and remove the cartridges. If so, the ink may seep out of the cartridge. If you mix the colors by installing an ink cartridge in the wrong position, clean the printhead. Once you have opened an ink cartridge, install it in the machine and use it up within 6 months of installation.
Use unopened ink cartridges by the expiration date written on the cartridge package. Do not dismantle or tamper with the ink cartridge. This can cause the ink to leak out of the cartridge. That's what I was saying. Brother strongly recommends that you do not refill the cartridge provided with your machine. We also strongly recommend that you continue to use only genuine Brother brand replacement ink cartridges. Use in an attempt to use a potentially incompatible ink and cartridge in the Brother machine may cause damage to the machine and may result in unsatisfactory print quality. Our warranty cover does not apply to any problem that is caused by the use of unauthorized third-party ink cartridge. To protect your investment and obtain premium performance of the Brother machine, we strongly recommend you use ink supply. Now that's all it says about. Oh, print quality. That's a print. Oh, that's just when you print it out. That's all that they give. They don't tell about the ink gauge, or they don't tell about the message that comes on there. But like I say, that's for their protection.
Yeah, but how do you do it?
Well, like I say, on the Hewlett Packard, it says I can push it has a little arrow, which means this one here.
Yeah.
The press. And then it will say, if you want to go ahead and use the machine, press OK.
But I'm wondering, maybe
this cartridge,
is well, the reason I put it. The message said time to take cover, right? It said it says like this.
Yeah.
Picture. I took it out and put it back in, but I didn't try to.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Maybe if I did that, maybe it'll work.
I don't think so, because there's a sensor inside. I don't know what happened to it. But anyway, you see, they got, this is where the sensor is, and that goes inside. And it, once that gets, once you pull it out, you almost need a new one to reset that. There's no other way to reset it. Even if you put ink in it, it don't reset.
So
some way or another, one of those isn't one of those things or is keeping you from starting the thing up. I think that's what the problem is. I don't know.
So you think that I have to buy a new one? I can't buy a kit. I have to buy a new one. Cartridge. That's what you think?
That's what I think.
Well, I was trying to get
I'm trying to see the date. 11/20/13. These would be out of date in 20th of this month. 11 is November. This is out of date. This is the 12th.
You think that that would have something to do with it?
Yeah.
Why?
Why?
Yeah.
Because that's the way they make the machine. That when it locks up like that, because of you either taking it out and put it back in or something, the sensor, you that little ball there is the sensor right there. That's where all the information is, right in there. Some way or another, they've got it rigged up. Those are the same way, that when you take it out, that sensor's got to be reset. That's apparently the way Brother works. That's not the way Hewlett Packard works. Hewlett Packard, you can fill them and put it back in and it'll still work.
I see. Well.
But being that these are getting close or out of date, have we got a full set here?
Yeah.
Take a set and put it in. Put the new set in. So these are going to be out of date, and when he comes, I'll just say, hey, you're out of date. If he comes. If he hasn't come this... Let's see, black, yellow, blue. I gotta meet my sister at 1 o'clock.
Yeah, okay.
Blue, red. We got a red. The blue was down. Okay,
right.
That's a blue. Don't pull your red one out, and put these three new ones in. And being that you haven't pulled the red one out, I'm assuming. And I get myself in trouble when I assume that the sensor is all right in that one yet, as long as you haven't taken it out.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? And as long as it isn't empty or down.
Yeah.
Your red one. So that's why I say, I'm thinking the red one's all right. But probably one of these is the one that's bad. But put all three of them in and see what happens.
You wanted to take this?
I want you to take, yeah. Those are yours.
Okay.
I'll give them to you.
Okay.
Because like I say, they're almost out of date. They're not out of date yet. But they'll be out of date the 20th of this month. But it don't know. There's no way that machine can read the date that's on there to know that it's out of date. There's no way. So that's why I'm saying they do that to protect their machine. They want you to buy new tapes.
Yeah.
So that's the only reason they're talking about this. The date's expired. Also, they will go by the machine. When you got the machine, you got a date that was in there when you started using the printer. So they will say, oh, it's out of date.
Can I use this?
What color? Is that red?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I missed it. I was looking for a red one.
Red? Yep. Yellow? Okay. Thank you.